Hey, what's up? Today I want to talk about the Ontario M3 trench knife right here. Now, I shopped for a while. I wanted a good WW2 World War II trench knife, something that was just a piece of history. And I thought about the Boker for a while, and I ended up settling on the Ontario strictly because they're still made in America. The Boker, although they supplied these same knives during the war, they have recently, well, since then, changed their production line over to China. And I just wanted a fully American, US-issued M3. And that's what we have here from Ontario. The sheath is real cool. I've seen the metal ones, but I like this one better. It has a leg strap hole down here, and this piece of leather did come down in that hole. But honestly, I like it up here a little bit more because I can hang it on the wall when I'm not using it. Or it's just out of the way. You can still put it on the belt and then it's down there. So you have a piece of leather if you ever need it. And I can always string some paracord up. I plan on putting some paracord through that if I ever need a leg strap. A couple things about this blade. Ontario, their old school tactics have not changed. This handle, leather on this handle came extremely dry. First thing I did was I threw some mink on it. Actually, I'm one coat in. I'm going to do another one. You can see it kind of caked up on the inside there. But then there's certain parts that are like dried out real quick overnight. I'm going to hit that up as soon as this is over. Another thing about the blade, it came sharp. I read reviews where the Ontario's didn't come sharp. Mine came sharp. I do have a slight kink. I mean, I saw a review on a video and one was way worse. This one doesn't bother me, honestly. And right here, it's US M3 Ontario 1943. Pretty cool in the engraving. The one I saw online, it was like a way off kink. This one, it truly doesn't bother me because I feel like it's 1943. You know, the wars are humping. They're pumping these things out as fast as they can. And they're not going to be perfect. Will it do the job? All day long. Is it exactly specs perfect? No, it doesn't have to be. But it has the kickback, the thumb ramp for pushing. Feels really good in the hand. For the price, you can't beat it. You can always find one that was actually in the war, but you're gonna pay for it. This is the exact same thing. It just hasn't been the war yet, you know. And it's great. The tip, it grabs your finger like crazy. It's super sharp. As you can see, the edge runs all the way down this side. Has a partial blade on that back side. But I tell you, this is just as sharp, and it's not going to slow this part from entering anything. One thing, it does have the peen, rat tail peen, whatever it's called. The Boker, I noticed, did come with a pin. Oh wow, this one has a pin too. I just noticed it in the daylight. Where is it? You can see it right there. Cool. I'm glad it has a pin. I was worried about that. Nice. But when I first got it, it was a little like it was tight, but then I hit something and then just loosened up just a tad, and I didn't realize it had a pin in it. But I pointed it up against a wall, cross grain, and then just took a hammer and tapped it right here just to snug it all together, and it worked. I haven't had any issues with it. I've been using it some, tightened up, you can squeeze it, you can feel that oil just doing its job. Probably a week's time, it'll be like butter. And as this black coating rubs off, it's only gonna look more and more legit. And a lot of people online are saying that you can't, like, this is just nothing but a poker. And no, it's not ideal for, like, bushcraft or, you know, there's always going to be a specific blade. We live in a world where companies are making specific blades for specific jobs and your specific hand. You know, it's like, so don't get all caught up in that. It's any sharpened edge is still better than nothing when you need a tool. And I just want to demonstrate a little. Like, right here, we just, you know, is it the biggest branch? No. But it's enough to do a lot with. Just give it the break there. All right, let's say we're out in the woods, you know. Oh boy, we need a notch. Do we need our $200 Gerber? No, we're stuck with the M3 because that's all we had when the plane went down. So the plane went down, we're on the island. We need a notch for survival, guys. We have a notch, it's gonna hold our rope. If it's not deep enough, guess what? We can always go a little deeper. That's what she should. I couldn't help it. That's what she said. Deeper notch. Oh no, my knife isn't good at killing things. Let me make a spear. Again, is it ideal for bushcraft? No. But it's a knife, guys. They gave this to soldiers. It wasn't just for stabbing. You know, it's doing anything you need it for. Maybe getting your money back at the poker table. I mean, the world's crazy about, what are they called? I don't know, whatever these are. Sticks that flare. You know, start your fire. Ooh. Yeah, well, this is totally new to me. I've never even heard of it till about 6 months ago. So, whatever. Now, this thing, this kind of metal, if you ever had an Ontario blade, especially the old school ones, I'm going to go in there. I'm going to clean it and leave it with a thin coat of oil. I'm also going to throw more mink oil on this leather. And, you know, just do that a little bit after use. It'll definitely last you a lifetime. Ontario. M3 trench knife. Really doesn't get any better. No damage after the wood. That white on the blade, that's where I stuck it into the wood to hammer to tighten the handle up. And again, I've been trying to break it loose just so I can tighten it again so I can do a harder job. That way I know I got it. But I feel like I got it now. And if it ever happens again, I'm just going to tap it in. All right. I appreciate you checking out the video. I'll see you next time I have something cool.